Is it recording?
Yeah.
I mean, all kids like to draw, right? I just drew more than them. I just kept doing it. And like, it was fun doing it. I used to make all sorts of different stuff. I used to read comics a lot, I think that. And watch cartoons.
What kind of comics?
Stuff like Tintin, Asterix, Archie's, although Archie's kinda sucks. One of my biggest inspirations is this guy Egon Schiele. I have a big book on him.
Oh yeah.
So I think a lot of my scribbly kind of style comes from this guy. Yeah. And you see, even though it's like shaky, each bump kind of shows like a muscle that's really there. You know, he knows his anatomy really well. So, yeah.
People ask about how you get a style, you know, like a unique voice in the as an artist. But like, you must have heard that, I don't know who said it, Picasso? He said, good artists copy, great artists steal. So the thing is that you got to stop pretending like people are unique. Everyone's inspired by some other thing, and it's every phase, whether it's in comedy or art or music or anything, it's a improvisation on the previous, all the work that's led up to that point. So if you want a unique style, you should thoroughly study certain artists that you really like, how they do it, and then you mix them together. I mean, whatever, you don't even have to consciously mix it. If you just study enough separate people, and you just make your own stuff, then your stuff will be a new thing which is made out of those inspirations. I've had exhibitions. I've had 3 exhibitions. That's when you really get to see people's feedback, you know. When they're all there. And usually, this is my first exhibition, and I think the second one. Almost everyone who bought that, anything that I made, were like, I'm gonna sell this for more later. And like, give me that money now. I'm the person who made the art. But whatever, man. People see it as an investment if they don't care about the actual. But I mean, if you're like a true artist, you don't. You're not in it for what other people say. The point of the swirls is that it's about fluid dynamics, you know? Like that's, it's a way to get like infinite detail in your painting. Cause I'm not the one making the swirls, you know? I put two pigments together and I half mix them. And you half mix them. Like, even the way like when you dip a brush on the top of the liquid, you see the paint mixing on the surface. I think that shit's really beautiful, you know. Like, fluid interactions is where most beauty comes from, at least according to me. And the swirls are how you capture that. And you can stare at them forever. And I mean, the fact that my painting's acrylic, most people don't encourage this, but I encourage people to touch the paintings, you know? Because like the texture is also part of it. It's just like, I try and make, at least with the swirls, I try and just make like a treat for the eyes, basically. It's just because we are humans we are really into patterns and textures and stuff like that. It's very innate. And like whether you understand art or not, you're gonna like the swirls and you're gonna like how they feel on your fingers. So. Thank you.